All right, what is going on, people of the internet? Welcome to the series where, unlike Wildcard, we prioritize optimizing ARC. Today we're going to be taking a look at the island. This is going to serve as a somewhat of a companion or a follow-up video to my ARC map retrospective on the island, in that we're going to be taking a look at the island and we're going to discuss some of the changes that you can make in your game in order to better optimize your experience on playing this map. So, to do that, we're going to have to look at what this map does well and what this map needs to do better on. Then we're going to pick out mods that are selected by myself, and we're going to take a look at rates that we can use in order to better optimize the entire experience and get the most that we can out of it. Now, there are a million different ways to play ARC. None of them are the correct way. You might have your own way of playing this, I have my own way, and everybody else might have their way as well. These mods might not necessarily work in the future either, and there might be different mods that I don't even know about that could completely overhaul this experience and make it the best that it possibly could. These are simply just mods and rates that I would recommend, and if I were hosting a server today, I would likely run with. So, let's first talk about what the island does well, what the island doesn't do so great on, and what we just shouldn't really touch. So like I mentioned in the retrospective video, the island is a map that struggles with duality a lot. There are a lot of different things that this map does well, and a lot of different things that this map does poorly, but the worst offender by far is the fact that this map has a lot of endgame content, but it also has a lot of early game content, and it does very little to blend those two things together. So, that being said, I could really see several different ways that you could run the island, but I can't really confidently speak on the behalf of a new player. As it stands at the current moment, I have about 3,000 hours in ARC. And I feel like I couldn't confidently speak on how to optimize this map for a new player because I'm relatively disconnected and I don't really want to speak on something that I don't know very much about. So today, when optimizing this map, I'm going to try and tailor it towards an endgame experience. The reason I think that you would play on the island rather than a map like Ragnarok or the Center or other similar vanilla maps would be the fact that I think that the island is a good map if you're trying to go back and experience things that you otherwise wouldn't have already. For example, I mentioned I had 3,000 hours in ARC. Believe it or not, I've never actually gone and defeated the Overseer without, you know, going in with admin commands just to do it to get the achievements. I've never actually sat down, played on the island, and gone and farmed my way up to being able to go beat the Overseer. So that would be a reason for me to go back and play on the island as well. I think that there's a bit of nostalgia towards this map. If you want to go back and relive some of your earliest memories when you first picked up this game some 5.5 years ago, I'm not sure that there's any other real reason to play on the island. There are definitely better maps for pretty much every other experience in the island. But that being said, let's assume that you are going back to the island for these specific reasons. How could we possibly optimize the experience to make it as painless as possible? So first and foremost, let's discuss mods. Personally, I'd recommend against adding any mods that add additional creatures. This is mainly just because the island is a really small map and there's a ton of different creatures on it already. So while something like Arc Editions, for example, is an excellent mod and certainly one of my favorites, I think that there are better maps for running this mod than the island because of the fact that the island is just too small to accommodate more creatures than it already has. It already feels too small to begin with. So let's not mess with that too much. So to begin with, and as for any map really, I would recommend adding S+, some form of stacking mod, and some form of a reusable mod. These three mods are pretty much staples on every single server that I would ever consider running. I don't think that you could possibly consider playing ARC without any of these mods in the current age. It's not worth your time farming bolas, it's not worth your time farming excess parachutes, spears, any of that sort of thing. I like reusable mods, stacking mods speak for themselves. It's ridiculous that you don't have meat stacking beyond like 100 or 20 or whatever the number is. I don't even remember because it's been that long since I played without a stacking mod. And Structures Plus is just an absolute must no matter what you're doing. Another core mod that I would consider for the island would be the custom dino level mod that I hinted at in the retrospective. This will basically make it so that all the creatures that spawn on this map will be following the Ragnarok level scheme. So you're not going to be dealing with a lot of low level creatures, and you will actually be able to get stronger creatures so that you can deal with the end game of this map better. And you can actually get creatures that spawn at high levels and you'll be able to defeat the bosses. And you won't have to go around the map and do constant dino wipes trying to just find a 150 Rex, for example. The other core mod that I would recommend running on the island would be the upgrade station. In my opinion, this is a bit overpowered and it kind of makes farming drops or cave drops a bit useless. However, the island really requires you to have a lot better gear than something like the Center would, and the upgrade station is a good mod for getting that sort of thing. It's still a little bit grindy, and it's still a little bit difficult to get these things, and I would definitely recommend capping the weapon damage or the armor at a certain percentage before the official cap, which I think is like 700% damage, which is just nuts. But in order to get yourself some better gear, I would strongly recommend adding the upgrade station mod as well when running on the island. And the final mod that I would highly suggest as a mod that you'd really want to run when playing on the island would be the Omnicular. There are a lot of different spyglass mods that you could possibly run when playing Ark, but I personally find the Omnicular to be my favorite. It gives you important information such as health and torpor when you press N on your keyboard without cluttering your screen with a lot of unnecessary stuff. And another mod that I've played around with is a Super Spyglass, but I feel like that mod just kind of includes too much information. When you're able to see every single stat of a creature, there's really little incentive to actually tame most of them. So I feel like it kind of subtracts from the overall experience, where Omnicular, I think, finds a nice balance. Beyond these six mods are ones that I would definitely consider to be more optional, that you could probably change out with ones that you might find better or worse or anything like that. But most of them are going to be building mods. So the first one that I would recommend is Mr. Rad Tools Inc. This adds a ton of different walls that you can use to perimeter off your base, and I really personally like it. I think they look excellent. You can make a lot of really, really cool looking bases with these. They include a ton of different gates, and you can just really make a lot of really interesting looking, very much dinosaur feeling bases that feel like they would actually be able to contain some of the dinosaurs that you're housing. Second one would be Eco's RP Decor. I would consider this to be almost a staple mod, but it is, at the end of the day, more of an aesthetic change rather than a core gameplay one. I would also include versatile rafts, because the island has a little bit of water that you can take advantage of to get around to different parts of the map, especially in early game. Meat Spoiler, for obvious reasons that don't really need stating, and Castle's Keeps, I think, is a good mod. Not that it necessarily fits the island the best out of any map, but Castle's Keeps includes a lot of different unique-looking building structures that I think can make a really nice-looking base if you put the work and the effort into it. And finally, the last mod that I would recommend would be the color tweaks, which just makes it so that your dinosaurs will spawn with a bit more vibrant colors. Helped to liven up the map a little bit. So obviously I haven't recommended a lot of mods to be running on the island. This is mostly just because of the fact that I think that this map requires a lot of nostalgia to really get the full amount of enjoyment out of it. And while this map is a very familiar one that pretty much everybody has some sort of experience with, so it could handle a lot more mods, I think that for returning players, it's better not to tinker with it too much, because that way you'd be able to really relive the essence of Ark and the essence of the island in its most vanilla state. So I would more recommend using quality of life change mods on a map like the island rather than full overhaul ones like you could for different other maps. So with the mods taken care of, let's start to talk about more of the rates that you should be running when you're playing on the island. I should probably preface this by saying that I'm a PvE player. I probably should have mentioned that at the beginning of the video. And the way that I like to play Ark is I don't like to be immediately rushed to endgame, and I like to more enjoy the route to it. I find that sometimes if you're playing on something like 20 times XP, sometimes you'll find yourself being able to tame things like Rexes without ever really being able to enjoy some of the earlier creatures like Raptors or, you know, Sabertooth or anything like that. So I like to more have gentler rates, but still be able to get into those higher end tiers. So starting off, I would recommend setting XP to 6 times, with the caveat that as soon as you hit player level 85, which is when the wall really starts to hit, I would probably double that to 12 times XP. This will make it so that you can get to endgame relatively well, and you'll be able to level up your teams, but it also won't rush you through the entire game, and you won't have no experiences with early game, and being able to run around with things like a bow and arrow, or hide armor, or chitin armor, or these other things that you wouldn't normally be able to experience if you're playing with 20 times or 50 times XP. Secondly, I would set taming to 12 times. This makes it so that you still have to put a little bit of effort into taming creatures, perhaps considering setting up defenses or guarding them or watching them over while they're taming, but it's not going to take you your entire day in order to tame a creature. I would set gathering to 8 times. I think that it's better to have gathering a little bit higher on a map like the island because of the fact that it's not really worth grinding out materials as so much as it is about getting the better dinosaurs in order to fight these bosses and go into these caves. So 8 times gathering, I think, will make it so that you can build relatively any size base that you want without putting terribly much effort into it, and it synergizes nicely with some of the mods that we've selected. For maturation, I have 3 different settings that I've chosen to alter a little bit. Maturation is set to 12 times, mating interval is at 0.05 times, and cuddle interval is at 0.33 times. At 12 times maturation, you'll be able to raise pretty much any baby from newborn to fully grown within a single day. It'll probably take you at most about 6 to 8 hours in order to raise absolutely anything. And it's paired very nicely with 0.33 cuddle interval multiplier, because you'll only need to do it maybe twice or three times for like the most high-end creatures in order to get them fully raised up. 0.05 times mating interval makes it so that you can breed your creatures a lot, which is of course very important if you're going to try and fight some of these harder bosses. And then finally, for crop growth, I've selected 50 times, and for egg hatch speed, I've selected 50 times as well. I don't like waiting on these things. I think it's ridiculous you have to sit around and wait an hour for an egg to hatch, so 50 times egg hatching will make it so that you only need to do at most like 2 minutes for even a Giga or a Quetzal or anything like that. Finally, there are a few more server settings that I would change around in order to better optimize your experience. On the note of player leveling, I would make it so that you would get every single engram every time that you level up. None of this nonsense with having to spend engram points anymore. I think that as soon as you get a new level, you should automatically learn everything that you can craft along with that level. I would also make it so that per level, players gain 2 times more HP, so 20 HP per level, and same with stamina, 20 stamina per level. And then for weight and oxygen, I would both make it so that you get 50 pounds of carrying weight and 50 excess oxygen per level. This makes it so that your player is a little bit easier to get out of that early game, and it makes it a little bit easier to get to, say, 300 or 500 HP as well, 500 carrying weight, so you can carry around more items with you and not be encumbered. And I think this streamlines the player a little bit further to make your gameplay experience just a little bit nicer in general. And finally, the last changes that I would make would be setting the official difficulty to 5.0, making it so that the max level dinosaurs that would spawn on your map are 150. And I would set the supply crate loot multiplier to 3 times, making it easier to find ascendant stuff. In conclusion, I think that we can better optimize the island by bringing out its endgame qualities. This is accomplished by bringing in the custom dino level mod to make it so that it's easy to find creatures that are high level and worth taming, buffing the player's stats a little bit to make it so that you can have a little bit stronger of a player a little bit earlier than you normally would, and then changing the rates around just a little bit in order to better tailor for the experience that ultimately you'd want to be able to get out of a map like the island. I'm going to publish a collection on the Steam Workshop that I'll leave a link to in the description below, so if you're curious to see all of my mods that I would select for this map, they'll all be together there in that workshop link on the description, so feel free to check that out. On a bit of a side note, I've been running a Discord in which we play Ark every once in a while for the last 5 years, and we're actually planning on setting up a Ragnarok server this Friday, so if that sounds like it would be something that would interest you, and you've looked at some of the things that I've talked about today and feel like maybe this sort of gameplay experience that I try and tailor these maps towards could be something that you'd like to try out, we're going to be starting up a server on Friday, and of course it's going to be open invite for anybody who'd like to join it. It'll be PvE, and more stuff will be announced in the Discord when we're getting closer to that point. I don't want to take up too much more time, but I'd like to thank everybody so much for watching this video. If you have any rates or mods you like to play with, I'd be very curious to hear about them. Obviously, this community probably has a ton of different people from a ton of different areas of specialty in Ark, and I'd be really curious to hear what you guys have to say about the island and some of the stuff that you'd like to change around with this map. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you in the next episode of Whatever I Make. Peace.